This is the tale of the Ark of Eshka, the Hylian King Ganaremus, and the four unlikely heroes that must grow in unity of the spirit of the hero they received to stop him. After finding their way into the final chamber of the Temple of Power, our four heroes found themselves face to face with the final boss of the dungeon, Magmara. A Sheikah-made lava beast that regenerates its access lava. They quickly learned that all of their attacks would not work against this molten beast. Well, all except for a singular water attack that Gyarados sent off, which caused Pardon momentarily on contact. After finding a nearby pool of water hidden within the Magmara's chamber, they began pouring buckets of water on the large lava monster as if it had won a sporting event. At one point, Rova came up with a remarkably creative use for her bucket rune. Rather than scoop water, she decided to use it to scoop up Magmara's body, resulting in the boss shrinking down a size. This proved useful in making its attack hit a smaller area, but since it could regenerate its body using the pools of lava nearby, they'd first have to get rid of its source of healing. After a long and heated battle, they managed to get water over to each of the pools of lava, cutting Magmara off from healing itself. Gyarados ended up getting a little more cooked than the rest of them, resulting in being downed by a fiery attack. But in spite of this, the remaining group stayed strong as they drenched the living lava with enough water to harden its entire body, allowing them to spread it into dust, finishing off the fight and completing the dungeon. Upon exiting the Temple of Courage victorious, they found the heat outside to have gotten unbearably worse. They warped to Kakariko Village. There, they regrouped with Aneka and Karina, from whom they demanded lodging for the night. Once they'd gotten their bedding, they then discussed where they wished to head next. Everyone was in agreement that heading to Zora's domain would make the most sense since it was closest, except Rova, who was strongly against going to Zora. Despite her insisting and rather fishy reasoning, the group decided Zora was next nonetheless, in response to which she started running, as much as a humanoid fish can run on land, that is. Needless to say, it did not take long to catch up to her. Upon interrogating this wielder of the Triforce of Courage as to why she booked it like a coward, it was then revealed that this was because Rova had been framed for murder by her very own twin sister. She feared that if she went home to the Zora domain, she'd be arrested for crimes she did not even commit. Thus, our heroes will have to find a way to keep her from being recognized. What shenanigans will they get into this time, and how will they navigate this latest slippery situation? Let's find out.
He still wants to know the answer to the age-old question of how much can a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood. It's Viridian an adventure. He wants Viridian to stop asking about how much wood a woodchuck can chuck. We all know it's 23 kilos. It's Taya Swips. She can barely even spell woodchuck, let alone figure out the math for how much wood it could chuck. It's Black Rose Storm. He's still trying to figure out what a woodchuck is. It's K-Grove Vile. I'm Will, your game master who doesn't need no woodchuck. I'll chuck the wood myself. And this is ZeldaQuest! Welcome in! Hello, hello.
I'm still breaking up for me, but...
It's yeah.
Same. Oh, it yes. is. My webcam is yeah. like he's not even a cam bad. Anymore. It is just like a photo slideshow at on the stream.
Is anybody else hearing him very robotically?
Yep.
Nope. Oh yeah. Oh. Yeah. Sorry.
Theoretically, the stream's not hearing me robotically, but though I can see how. Okay. Well, interesting.
I will say, it's kind of weird watching the stream and seeing our cameras work better than...
Yes! It is very strange. I'm really glad that I ordered a new computer today. It will be here on Friday, and then the next time we do this will not be a problem. Oh my goodness. Wait.
Don't lie to your chat. You didn't order a computer. You ordered a laptop.
A laptop.
Listen, same difference.
Oh, it's not.
No, it's not.
It's like saying the CDIs are Zelda games.
Dang, that's a low blow.
So I'm assuming you're not adding that to your collection of completing Zelda games, hey?
Yeah, no.
We've got until May 12th. Better get to it.
That's true. Oh, man.
Good.
But yes, welcome in. All right. So yeah, this is just going to have to be the vibe is, I mean, the audio is the main and primary thing. And it seems that we have that down at least. So we take those.
Yeah. Seems good.
Yeah. For the most part, I'd say.
Yeah. If this gets really bad, we will switch over to Discord and do audio only, but for now, let's see how this goes. All right. Oh, yes, with the shades on. All right. You guys can see scrolling along the side of the screen. Oh, I'm pointing as if the camera's going to catch up and be able to see me pointing. There are credits rolling along. More additional links and stuff if you do exclamation point Zelda Quest in chat. Yo, Cats is in here and Alex, how are you guys doing today? And I saw Silver in there, and thank you guys for the hype train, by the way. That was poggers. That's the first hype train in a hot minute. Appreciate y'all. Woo. Alrighty.
Cat, I have like 6 more slices if you want one.
Thank you for that.
Yes, where is it? I keep muting my microphone so no one hears me chew. I'm eating pizza. Yeah.
I didn't even catch that. Fedora. What else could it be?
Alrighty. Alright, so we're just going to try jumping into this. And again, if this just gets out of hand, we'll switch to audio only and dish the cams. Yo, X Pearly. I don't think I've seen you around. Welcome in. Great to meet you. Unless I'm wrong.
Oh well.
All right. So for those watching the YouTube video, we just cut all the, like a lot of content all of a sudden. Wow, this episode is so much shorter than the others. Who knows why?
I know, right?
Yeah, really. Jeez.
It's not like we had a lot of technical difficulties or something.
Right. Nah.
Doesn't sound like one of our streams.
Nah.
Never.
Yeah. That doesn't happen.
All
that
righty.
Never happens. We're professionals.
Dang right.
We sort of know what we're doing, kind of.
Right.
Okay, so when we last left off, you guys were like, heading off to bed, but I believe Teus, you had Guy heading to the library or something.
Let's retroactive that and just say you went to bed as well.
Okay. So, that's right. No, the library was closed, and he was going to next morning anyways. That's right. Yeah. So yeah, it's a new day. I believe we're on the 5th day now, or something like that. Yeah, let's go with that. You guys wake up. The weather is finally nice, which it's not been all that nice for like the past couple of days. So to finally have like it's still kind of cloudy. It's just kind of like partly to mostly. It's like half cloudy.
Well, at least it's better than rain.
yeah, or intense heat. Yeah,
but intense heat is fine. What are you talking about?
It's still a little humid out, but you know, it's comfortable. It's humid but comfortable. Yeah.
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 That makes sense.
What do you guys do?
Mm.
Oh, Basky. How's it going? How are we doing this morning?
Who are you talking to in this instance?
Talking to the world, my dude.
All right, everyone.
He just wakes up in his own bed and just kind of looks around at the rooms like, sound brisky.
All right, everyone. Morning huddle. Share the energy.
What is this huddle you talk of?
We need to address the large Zora in the room. I don't know what they have in it as equivalent to elephants in this world, but...
Good question.
We have the large Ruta in the room.
The Stalnox in the room.
Yeah, we need to address the Hinox in the room.
Hinox in the room, yeah.
And that is the fact that Zora is going to be an issue. But after a full night of thinking that felt like a month, it was crazy. I may have a plan. And that is a broken spell called Impa's Disguise that I can use to disguise myself. However, with that said, it kind of works, but like if anyone gets close to me or like touches me or anything, like they'll notice that I'm disguised as someone else.
Yeah, that is fine.
So we need to prevent that from happening. And so what I was thinking is to prevent that from happening because like no one would get close to royalty like Princess Zelda. So like what if I pretend to be Zelda and Zelda turns into like her Lionel form or something and pretends to be the fourth hero?
I think that would draw even more attention to you than what you would want.
Yeah, especially once we get to like, what is your plan for addressing the king? Because I would have to, you know, talk to the king as if I'm me.
Exactly. Not only that, but the Zora lived for a very long time last time I checked. So they would be able to spot Zelda right away. So if you look like Zelda, I'm sure she has a bunch of fish fans.
I don't think age has to do with that.
Okay, well then I'll just be a random Hylian then.
I don't know what the fish people do. I'm taking guess.
That could work.
The goal is to not be recognized.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll blend right in.
Probably.
Of course you will blend right in. You are a Zora fish person.
Right. Then he winks.
What are you doing?
What if he's not a Zora? He's been disguised this entire time.
I'll blend in perfectly. He says it out loud this time and winks.
Oh my gosh. Okay, you do whatever it fish, man.
Yeah.
I am very concerned.
Alright, does anyone have anything else they want to add to this plan, or should we just go for it?
No, go for it. Just fish.
Okay, and by the way,
I could become a gopher. Could disguise myself as a gopher.
What'd you say, Taz?
Everybody's PNGs are done.
Oh, what? Cool.
Neat. Except for yours, Fedora, but I assume you don't need one.
Nah, I'm going to be all sorts of... I guess if there's a character that I'm going to be more often than not, it would be Zelda, but still I'm going to be too many other characters.
That's fair.
Mm. Alrighty. Yeah.
Roma's mouth looks amazing.
What?
Oh,
happened?
My word.
Oh, did you post these all in that? Oh, no.
I think the craziest one is Roma.
I love it.
I'm not gonna lie, I kind of just started and I was like, yeah, this is it.
Damien would be proud of what you've done with their art.
I love it.
Oh, no.
Also, it's Damien's birthday today, so happy birthday to Damien.
Really?
Happy birthday, Damien!
Yeah. Oh, speaking that's awesome. Damien, did they stream today?
I don't know.
Heck. All right. Well, anyways.
Where do I find these PNGs? I can't.
They're in the PokeQuest, ZeldaQuest.
Oh, so you haven't seen yours yet. That's even better.
Oh, it's so much better.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I was in the ZeldaQuest. Okay.
Yeah, he went in the public one that everyone can see.
Yeah.
Well, that's great.
Isn't it? Looks amazing, don't it?
Exclamation point Discord here. You guys, anyone that isn't in the Discord can join and see this utter nonsense before it appears on your screen.
It's not nonsense. What? It's art. It's beautiful.
It's something. It's something.
Y'all need to leave Taz alone. Jeez.
Nah, fine.
I appreciate it, Taz.
I'm very proud of the work.
I'm very proud of it. It looks great.
Yeah. Am I a cat now?
I mean, you wanted a disguise, right?
I guess.
Fair enough.
They'll never know.
Oh, my goodness.
We're just throwing Skyrim into this campaign as well. He's just part Khajiit now. Or she's Khajiit now, I guess.
Pretty much.
Making a whole new species.
Yep.
All right. So what do you guys do now? So you had the huddle. You figured out the stuff. You guys do any errands around town?
I guess.
No, I'm good.
Okay, so you were going to go to the library, right?
I don't even remember why I wanted to go to the library.
Well, you should go to the library.
Sure, yeah, I'm going to the library.
I knew that you said you were going to go.
That's true, I did say that, so I'm going.
To research something like about the ingredient you were looking for or something?
I think so. I'm just gonna head over to the library.
What we can do is just say that you went there, and honestly, it's probably for the best that we leave it a mystery what actually happens while you're at the library. In the meantime, we can cut to the others.
Yes, we'll find out in the finale. You'll come back.
Yeah. I
found the book.
What are the rest of y'all doing while around town?
I want to go buy bombs.
I thought you could make bombs.
No. I can make Goron spices.
That's the same thing, isn't it? You can make some spicy bombs.
By the way, Radiant and Grovile, if you guys go into that Fuji Tech site, you should be able to hook up those images.
Yeah, I'm trying to do that. I'm having a fun time trying.
So all you have to do is you got set an active image and then set active speaking image, right? You just say no. You see the spot where it says no file chosen. Click on it. You choose the file that's for you're not talking.
Oh, I know. Yeah. I got it on my end. I just couldn't find the files.
Ah, that's a you problem.
Yeah, I got it. Okay. Save, done. We're good.
Oh, yep, there it is.
Told ya.
Now Grovile's the one slacking.
I'm working on it. keep going.
Oh, boy. But anyways, so shopping for bombs, you said?
Yeah, I want to go find some bombs. I need to buy some.
As luck would... Well, no. Actually, roll a luck check.
Can't let me have nothing. Okay, so a luck check is...
2d6,
what again?
Just 2d6 without any modifiers.
Okay.
Yeah. A 5. There is like a You go into what kind of stores do you look for?
Stores that sell weapons and ammunition, I guess, would be the best place to go.
Okay, so you find a blacksmith, you know, there's a rough, gruff guy with just kind of like a 5 o'clock shadow on his face, not very clean shaven, but not really fully bearded. And he's just hammering away on something. He looks up and he's like, what?
Hello, comrade. I was looking if you had any bombs that I could buy.
I've got one or two, not much.
Okay, I will buy them if you have them.
Okay.
Also, do you have any big sledgehammers?
Oh, I got sledgehammers.
Oh, excellent. My guys get like all giddy at the thought of that. He's like,
all right, let me see. Where's the... Is it under ammunition, bombs, and their cost?
They would be... Yeah, yes. They would be under ammunition, yes. I think.
Market price for a bomb is 20 rupees. So if you want both of them, that'd be 40.
Okay, that's fine.
And then you said a sledgehammer.
Yeah, like big sledgehammer, like two-handed sledgehammer.
Most are. If it wasn't two-handed, it would be a hammer. Wouldn't be very sledgy.
Fair enough.
Does this give costs here? Let me see. Ah, here we go. Weapon rank. We're going to go with just market value. So no haggling.
The best sledgehammer that you've got.
He does have a... Roll luck.
Here we go again. Don't be bad. Don't be bad. Gosh darn it.
Oh, no.
Oh, man. I was going to, like, give you a rank two, but now that you rolled snake eyes, I feel it's appropriate that the best he has is rank one. Which is better than zero,
I guess. Not that great.
No.
Crap. Wait, what is it exactly? Like, the name of this? Is it a traveler sledge or a makeshift sledge? I don't know which one it is.
So rank one is, let me see here. I believe rank one is travelers, if I remember right.
I think that's right, because I have rank one and I have travelers, so...
Yeah, rank one is travelers, rank zero is makeshift.
Okay, I'll buy it.
All right, you are now the owner of a traveler sledgehammer for 100 rupees.
That's fine.
Woo.
I have plenty of money. It doesn't bother me.
It is Sheikah style.
Ooh.
So there's that. Okay. Give you a proficiency in, let's see. Wait. Yeah. So Sheikah style has two bonus attack, since it's rank one, so minus two in durability.
Minus two in durability?
Yes, and plus two in attack. Yeah.
Two. Okay. All right, that's fine.
Anyone else wanting weapons or, you know, anything of the sorts or anything buying?
Go.
No.
No. No.
Actually, I want to buy a bow and some arrows.
Buy your own bow. Nice.
Yeah. Do I have to roll a luck check for that too?
Yeah, to see what ranks they have available here.
Are we able to repair, get things repaired?
Of course.
You can ask. Oh, that's a great roll. Dude, that's awesome.
I'm at the library, so I can't ask right now. But...
Yeah. Well, once you're done with the library.
Yeah. Of course.
Yeah, yeah. But the rank... So they do have a rank 3 bow for 400 rupees.
Yeah, I'll buy it.
Do they have any other bows at this same shop?
And I'll also buy out any bomb arrows or fire arrows that they may have.
I'll get you ammo in a second.
Yep, no worries.
Yeah, that rank, that was the only rank 3 that they had. Rova, if you want, you can roll your own luck check to see if they have a rank 2. But they definitely have rank 1s.
And I just bought it.
No, you bought the rank 3.
Yeah, the rank 3 bow. Yeah.
Also in Sheikah style. So again, with the plus 2 attack, minus 2 durability.
I'm trying to find...
No, not minus 2. Since this is a rank 3, that would be minus... that would be minus 4 on durability.
Minus 4, okay.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to find the weapons themselves, and I can't find it on the homebrew wiki.
Ooh. Groval, you are just in luck. They do have a rank 2.
Okay, how much is rank 2?
200.
Yeah, okay.
All right, you buy the rank 2 bow.
Yeah, I can't find the stats for, like, the bows and stuff. Like, the weapons. I don't know where to find that.
Let me see what I have down for Zelda, because she has the basic one. Oh, I didn't write down the durability on hers.
Because, yeah, I'm under weapons in the homebrew wiki, and I can see, like, the crafting styles and the pricing and all that, but...
So in the appendices at the very bottom, there's there. That's where you will find it.
Oh, appendices. Okay.
Here we go. So rank 3
weapons.
Oh, this. Yeah, no. This is what you need.
What?
The appendices weapon listing has everything.
Okay, rank 3. Gotcha.
Oh, it's a knight's bow. There you go.
Ooh, fancy. I'll add that.
All right. And then the rank 2 one, that's a soldier's bow. Accuracy 4. In this case, the attack would be 11, and the durability would be 7 for that rank 2 there. Profile.
Got it.
All right.
Building.
And then you guys asked about ammo.
So that's minus 2 to durability, right?
So the minus for the durability is the rank plus 1. And that's what you subtract for Sheikah.
Okay.
So for your rank 3, that would be minus 4.
Gotcha. So, okay. But it's plus 2 attack.
Yes.
Okay. Gotcha.
Yep, that's the trade-off.
Okay.
All
could
right.
Could be worse. Could be better.
Yeah. So, arrows. They have as many arrows as you want to buy, really. Up to 100. 5
Ooh.
Each.
Ooh.
Bomb arrows, they have a single pack of 10 for and they require you to buy it in a bundle for 250.
Okay. That's fine.
How much are the normal ones?
Five each.
Five rupees for one arrow?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
What is this economy?
The inflation. Do they have any fire arrows?
Oh my God.
No.
How many packs of arrows do they have, like regular arrows?
They have like a total of 200, dude.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, and then. Oh, hold on.
All right, while you guys figure that out,
yep.
Are you doing anything, Zanzi?
You know that, so if you head up towards where the ferry is, there's a pathway off to the right where it's just like a cliffside to look over. I'm going to be sitting over there just kind of looking over.
Ah, yes. It should be noted that that ferry location no longer houses a ferry, sadly. As, you know, there's just been a lot of urbanization. And once that got too close to her, it said that the ferries started to relocate at that point.
No.
They're still around, but they're in new locations.
That's fine. They scare me anyway.
All right. I'm going to buy 50 arrows.
You do so. Are we like, what?
250.
Yeah, that one. Alrighty.
Yeah, I'm good.
Alright, so Teus, when you come back, when your character comes back, you've had like your eyes open to something, and there's definitely something in the library you found that you know you should not have found. And then you regroup. You probably meet up with Zanzi's on the outskirts. You probably meet up with the two that were shopping.
Right. Yo. How's it going?
It is going good. I bought myself bomb arrows, so now I can explode things from a distance.
That's cool.
What is up your fishtail, friend? You look like you've seen ghost.
Yo. I mean, aren't the spirits all around us?
I don't know.
Oh. I thought... Wait. Are they not?
I don't know.
Oh, this is breaking my brain. Give me a second here.
You tell me. I don't know.
Wait. Everything has an essence. So is everything a ghost?
Good question.
Are you a ghost?
I don't think so. Are you a ghost?
I don't... Wait, am I?
I don't know.
Yo, you're breaking my brain. Why are you asking about ghosts?
Because you look like you've seen one.
No. What? Why are we talking about ghosts?
You tell me.
You tell... I'm confused. What's happening?
Guy hurts himself in his confusion.
Yeah, it's super effective.
Oh boy.
So, bomb arrows.
Yes, I am excited.
What's up with that?
Well, I bought this knight's bow, so now I will be able to fire the bomb arrows from far distances and surprise our enemies with explosions.
Oh. Wait. But I thought we were supposed to be heroes. Feels kind of not heroic to blow things up from a distance.
We blow up our enemies. That is very heroic.
But what is an enemy, you know?
Well, the fact that you died like 3 times in that last dungeon, I would say pretty much anything that could kill you with a sneeze.
To be fair, that's a lot of things.
That is why I needed a lot of bomb arrows.
So wait, if it's anything that can kill me with a sneeze... Wait, can anything kill me with a sneeze?
I don't know. You need to find that out yourself.
This feels like the ghost question all over again. Why are we going in circles?
Alrighty. Meanwhile, Zanzi, Zelda comes up to you just while you're chilling on the cliff.
Hey, can I sit here?
Sure.
So,
she sits down.
What's your story?
What do you mean?
I don't know. What were you doing before this?
Nothing very interesting.
No?
No.
Well, then what was it if it wasn't that interesting?
Well, I was a thief.
Oh, interesting.
I said it wasn't interesting.
That's true. Well, I guess that's subjective. But... But yet the Triforce of Courage chose you. So, I mean, that must mean you have some heroic qualities of sorts, so I can't judge you.
I guess. Never really wanted to be chosen. I just wanted to be left alone.
Same.
You just show up.
The camera pans. I'm just sitting there.
You just hear it shouted from the distance. Same.
Secretly was there all along. Nobody noticed. Same.
Oh, sorry. Was it? Were you having a moment? I walk away.
Gee.
Rome is just like down in the river.
Swimming up a waterfall right next to you.
Yeah.
Do you want to be a hero?
No.
So.
Oof.
Heroics aren't really my thing.
Well, do you want to help people?
Depends on the context, I guess.
Well.
And it depends on what you mean by helping people.
Well, think about the other day when we helped that lady get her purse back.
I suppose.
You're suited for the job. I know you are.
My skills might be. That doesn't mean I want to do it. Again, I didn't ask to be chosen. I was hoping to be left alone. That's why I left the city.
I understand. I never chose any of this. I mean, I didn't choose for my own father to be, you know, the bad guy of this story and start, you know, wanting to wipe out all of his opposers and, you know, rule with an iron fist and all this stuff. And
she couldn't even kill her own dad.
Oh my god! Stop!
Okay.
Leave something alone!
You had one job!
They're and just hiding you on messed the other it up!
What are these? Was that directed at us?
I have no idea, nor do I.
Yeah,
care.
No, all of us are just standing there listening to this.
You hear in the distance, Da Cobrad!
Why do I feel like I'm being insulted from a long distance?
Because you are a Cobrad!
But anyways, it's... I understand, this is my point. Well, yeah. Sometimes it's just fate that puts you into this position, and you gotta learn to go with what your destiny has for you.
Fate, right. I'm gonna get up angrily suddenly and just start walking down the hill.
She will start following you down, then halfway down the hill be like,
did I offend you? Are you okay?
I'm fine. Don't worry about it. It's not you. No, I'm just gonna keep walking.
It's your dad.
Wow.
Did Gyro just jump from the waterfall? It's your dad.
You know what, Fishman?
I don't even know if this is happening or not. I'm just saying.
No, probably not.
Probably not.
It'd be funny if it was.
Alrighty. So, the whole group regroups. Everyone's back together. Yippee.
I had a very surreal feeling like we were making fun of somebody.
Wow. Yeah, so Zelda walks up and is like,
did I? No, never mind. What have you guys been up to?
I bought bombs and explosive arrows.
Not surprising.
What do you mean by that, comrade?
When have you not had bombs?
Fair point.
What did you get up to, guy?
Yeah, just reading. It's cool.
Okay, yeah, cool. Wait.
And she goes over to Zanzi and just whispers in her ear.
He can read?
Come on.
Like he said last time, he acts stupid. He's not, though.
Fair.
Blame the Hylian education system that your father made.
That's a Zora education system in this case.
Probably still made by the father.
Honestly, when in doubt, you always both blame your dad and credit your dad for everything.
or in this case, blame the government.
Yeah, that's the easier one to blame.
Because he's also the government.
Yeah.
So you blame both.
Could we blame the woodchucks?
Yeah, we still haven't figured out how much they can chuck.
No, it's,
I also
I
still don't know how to spell woodchuck.
Oh, that's right. I was going woodchuck. To. I had multiple points today. Thought, oh, I need to grab a log from my backyard so I can chuck that during the intro, and then I kept forgetting to.
Honestly, I was thinking of getting a piece of wood and just having it in my mouth.
Oh my
intro.
Gosh.
Oh, wow. Missed opportunities.
Yep.
Oh, well.
Alrighty. Alright, so, unless you guys are doing anything else in Kakariko, do you guys head on out?
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah.
What route do you guys take? The shortest route is to go up and over the mountains. There is no official road for that, so that will be off-roading it, but it's a lot shorter than having to go all the way around and up through the wetlands.
Let's do that.
Yeah, let's go up the mountain.
All right.
Do it.
You guys can. So the easiest path to do so would be swinging a little bit to the right towards that Lionel colony over like here.
Nope.
Why don't just go straightest route?
All right. Those mountains are especially steep, so that's going to take you quite a bit. By the time you get to this town up here, it is like dinner time.
I mean, we could also go this way.
That's what I was thinking you guys were doing.
Oh, okay. Sure.
How fast could I go up there if I was rolling as a Goron?
Downhill, great. Uphill, no.
Yeah, I don't know how you're propelling yourself fire rolling up a hill. That feels like it would take an incredible amount of core strength, also breaking physics.
I mean, have you seen him, though? Have you seen those abs, though? Like, I think he has the core strength.
What abs? What do you mean? I've seen the picture.
So 16. Say, yeah. Let's go with, like, I don't know, 640. Yeah, so about a 10 hours journey to get over this mountain.
Seems fine.
So like then by the time that you get down there, let's say you leave around 10, it would be, 8. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
8 at night.
Yeah. And that's if we don't run into any hiccups.
Yes. Oh, that's a good point. Oh, that's a great point. Actually, that's a good point. I am going to roll 2d6s for, you know, reasons.
I will say that we are avoiding the Lynels.
You are avoiding the Lynels. You are not going to encounter Lynels today.
So, bonus, I think.
But Lynels have also been apparently considered friendly in this game.
Yes-ish. It depends on what side of them you get. Some, you know, if they think that you're threatening their territory, they're territorial.
That sounded like a lawyer right there. It depends. Come on.
But I mean, we would just be passing through anyway, so we're not going for any territory anywhere.
I mean
that's what the last one said, and look what ended up to him.
Also, I'd rather avoid things that can hurt me / kill me.
Yes. No, that's fair. Oh no, they could probably one-shot you.
Probably.
Oh, I wouldn't doubt that for a second.
Yeah.
All right, can we give me, like, a little bit more faith?
No, I was saying the collective, no. All of y'all.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I'm always assuming that we're talking about me dying. To be honest.
I can see why you think that.
Yeah.
Now I kind of want to test my strength against a Lionel, see how long I could survive.
With your upgraded bow, you could probably do some damage, but the moment he hits you, you're done for.
Well, also, some Lynels have bows as well, so.
Yeah.
Ah.
Maybe not. Yeah. Maybe not a great call.
I mean, unless their power is higher than my evasion and defense and stuff.
Probably is.
Unless Will says, oh yeah, this Lionel has a sword and it does 100 HP to you.
Okay, I don't know. It depends.
Knowing Will.
All right. So you guys make it to, there is an encounter that you have along the way. It is against some some bokoblins. You run into some bokoblins along the way. Just one little group.
How many?
Like maybe. Let's say like two or three.
Are they close together?
Yeah, they don't see you yet, so...
Oh,
I want to shoot a bomb arrow at them.
Whoa, okay.
Okay, actually, no, yeah, just go ahead. We might not even need to roll for initiative here if you just pepper them off, actually.
As he's, like, launching that arrow off, I'm like, may peace not war.
We can always sneak past the...
Yeah.
Really?
Accuracy 10. What is the sick dodge numbers on a bokoblin? Let's see here.
Oh boy.
See, he's not really aiming for the bokoblins, though.
I was going to say, there's a radius there.
Yeah, I'm aiming for a radius. With the bomb arrow.
It's more like, do they notice it before it hits the ground?
Oh, absolutely not.
Oh, they're going to get hit.
Why does it say no? Wait, what? What is their HP? Why is there just a dash for
their
HP?
Well, it's zero now.
It's gone.
It knew.
What? Okay. I guess it just depends on what rank of bokoblin. Even a bokoblin bodyguard rank, like, so, like, there's peon, and then, like, berserker, bodyguard, all of these, that would one shot. So, yeah.
Hooray for the ball medals! I knew it was good purchase.
You know, we don't have to kill everything along the way.
Well, that was fun.
Okay.
Onwards.
Feels like it missed the point of what I was saying, but that's fine.
All right.
Well, those bokoblins sure didn't miss the point.
They never even saw the point.
They never saw the point. Yeah.
Oh my!
By the time they saw the point, it blew
the
up in their
face. The point was a little blunt and explody.
Yeah.
Point blew up in their face.
Kind of keeps walking. I think Guy's just gonna go and give a little Zora prayer to the little bokoblins.
Even though the bokoblins work for the evil one that we are trying to fight.
I mean, everybody's just trying to live.
And they would have killed you if they knew you were there.
I mean,
they would have
to know we were here.
Exactly, and now they really don't know.
Well, yeah, they're just defending their territory. Like,
all right, so you
are... The territory they stole.
So as you start coming down the mountain, you are approaching, like, habitated Zora, like, habitations. I don't know. Because there's more than just the Zora city. Every single group in Hyrule has been prosperous and now has, like, more than just one place that they exist. So the closest town that you guys... end up at is Bolfaro. These are all just randomly generated names. And shout outs to this amazing map generator. I assume at this point you go ahead and use your disguise there for Rova.
Yeah, I'm just gonna make myself look like
cat whiskers.
I'm just gonna look like a typical Hylian of little importance.
Can't forget the cat whiskers.
I feel like the cat whiskers would draw more attention.
I mean, I did draw them.
Yeah, actually, I'm gonna make myself look like Inteka. Exactly the same.
That's smart.
Does it change your voice as well?
Just don't talk.
Yeah.
Details about your appearance, including your race, gender, and warm armor. Doesn't affect the smell, sound, or tactile feeling of your person. Okay.
So, nope. Doesn't change your voice. So you look like a guy, but you sound like a woman.
I can put on a voice.
Time for voice acting.
Because he talks with a really high voice like this, right?
Well,
Honestly, I thought you were gonna be like Fedora and be like, wowee! Hi, everybody! No? Okay.
When have I ever said wowee, sir?
I don't know. I feel like you have. It feels like something you would say.
Yeah, it does. It feels like something he would have said at some point. Wee.
Like that, right there.
There we go.
Alrighty. Alright, so this town is a small town. Let's see. Oh yeah, it doesn't have a marketplace. It is really just like a one horse village type place. Well, kind of. It's on the way to Zora City. So it has enough people stop by for it to be like developed. It's a meetin'. It's not as big as Kakariko, but though it's not, it's definitely village sized. It's village sized.
I go to one of my buddies' houses. I have like a friend in every single town.
You just have a buddy in every town.
I have a place that I can always just go and chill. That's how I've lived my life, is by bumming off of other people.
Is Rova from Zora City or from a different town?
I'm from Zora's domain because the guard.
That's a country.
Yeah.
Sorry, like the main. Zora City. Her father was a capital. Was like one of the main. Yeah, he was a guard in the capital.
So. Yeah.
It has been a long time since I've been in Zora territory.
Same.
Feels like home.
Feels like.
Actually, it's been like 6 days for me since I've been home. Something like that.
Smells like there could be money to be made.
And I start rubbing my hands together.
Smells like we should be moving quickly.
Yo, I gotta.
And
I gotta
get in and out here as fast as possible.
Look,
is your rush? What is big issue?
I have explained big issue, good sir.
I feel like that was like, I know you explained it only like yesterday or something, but it feels like it's been like a month.
Weird. I feel like I heard an intro, like a whole recap thing about it just shortly.
That's crazy.
Like an hour.
Yeah. I feel like the spirit of someone that I used to know might have told us something about that in a short, under 5 minute spiel.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy.
It's crazy.
You should have been paying attention, I guess.
Insanity.
Long story short, Zoras hate me. We stay away from Zoras as much as possible.
Well, that is going to be kind of hard to do since there are Zoras that are walking all around us.
And that's why we're going to keep moving and not talk to anyone that we don't need to talk to draw any unwanted attention to ourselves.
It's getting dark, though, so should we, like, set up a camp or...
How
much farther is it to the city?
Yo, welcome in, Lieutenant Captain Bowser. Thank you for pressing the friendship button. Great to meet you, new friend. Welcome, welcome.
Watching you, Captain Bowser. Name like Bowser, you never know.
Better be staying away from my peaches. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, my word.
Oh, we're right there. We're not in the village yet. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. It depends on if you guys want to commit or not. But though you're like in the, that's why I was saying, like, you know, you would probably want to start to use disguise on the road so that, you know, in case of passerby.
Yeah, no, it stays on. It just takes up some of my magic while it's on, so I can keep it on indefinitely.
So how long is it going to take us to get to the Zora City?
150 minutes, which is
two and a half hours. I can't believe I did this that fast in my head.
Is it mostly just downhill from here?
You're going to be a big ball again, aren't you?
It's a little bit of both. A little bit of ups and downs. If you ball up, it would be like a roller coaster. Like, think of the path to the Zora's domain and the games where, like, you know, you kind of gotta follow the river up, or in this case, it's expanded to become a bit more of a lake.
Yeah, but we went up around a mountain. So, are we still, like, on the downcline of the mountain?
You're on a plateau.
Okay.
A great plateau?
No.
Oh. It's a mediocre plateau. Do be like that.
Definitely below average.
Definitely do be like that.
One sec. I feel like there's something we've been missing this entire session. Just
what
is it? There it is. There we go. We've been missing that this entire session.
That is true.
I just told one though.
Nah, it doesn't count.
No.
The new one.
Doesn't count.
Nope.
I'm never ready.
You should be ready.
Yeah, well. Okay, you guys keep talking, and I'll think of one. Because when everyone goes silent and like stares, then I can't think.
Okay, I mean, so
the unfortunate thing is we can't really stare at you right now.
Exactly. Only I can. I can. Well, you can't see my face. Well, if you look at the stream, you see my face.
I'm minimizing the stream now.
So if I roll up into a ball and just start barreling towards Zora City, how long could I get there? Or how fast could I get there? Could I get there in less than 2 hours?
The same speed as like running, right? At that point?
Slightly faster than running. My speed increases.
I would think that would like knock out your stamina.
It doesn't.
Running wouldn't?
No, rolling up in a ball and just rolling.
Is that like a specific ability or feature or something?
Yes. It's specific to Gorons that they can roll up into balls and just roll.
Is it specific, like in the rules, does it say that it won't reduce stamina?
It's 8 stamina bind, so I lose 8 stamina to roll up into a ball. My movement increases by 2, and when I uncurl from a ball, I regain that 8 stamina back.
Okay, increases by 2. Where's sprinting? Sprinting. Movement, sprinting. Your movement is... Oh, in this game, your movement's just straight up doubled when you sprint. Dang. But you have to sheath or stow any items or weapons. Oh, that's... Oh, interesting. You may sprint up over multiple movements. It doesn't say that there's a... stamina use. What?
Cool, so we can sprint indefinitely. Nice. Whistle sprinting at its finest.
Honestly, that sounds about right.
I knew there was glitches in this game.
Interesting. Why?
Who knows?
Doesn't make sense. That should use up some of your stamina. That really should. There's no way that doesn't.
Well, sounds like it doesn't in the rules.
But either way, so okay.
Guys, I have a joke.
The whole party needs to be able to go faster. Zelda does have the Lynel form.
Grovile's got a joke.
I've got a joke.
Oh, go ahead.
Why was Zelda sad after watching a YouTube video?
Oh no.
Why?
She couldn't find the link in the description.
That's pretty good. Pretty good.
Oh my gosh.
I do things sometimes.
Good, boy.
That's a good one.
See, I just need a moment to think.
Fair. I didn't feel like groaning that.
While people aren't staring at
that, I really appreciated that one.
Oh boy.
You get some clappy eevees. There you go.
Woo!
Alrighty. Okay, so you guys start making your way up. So you guys are just going to, even after sunset, just go ahead and schmoove on along for that 2.5 hours?
Yeah, I'm not running.
But... yeah, might as well.
Okay. And then are you going to just going to try to find a place there in the city? What are you going to do for the night?
I'm just going to find a friend's place.
There's always something somewhere in the city.
Yeah.
So you are going to find a place to stay in the city.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Including Rova?
I mean, inns are open, like, what, 24-7 anyway? So it's like...
yeah.
All right. Even Rova.
I mean, currently, my name is Inteka, actually. Don't you know?
Oh, brother.
All right. As it is nighttime, there's increased odds of there being, you know, stuff to run into.
Are we in the place?
No, not yet. You got like at least you got at least like 2 hours ish of.
Well, apparently somebody wants to commit genocide in this party, so I think we'll be fine, Fedora.
What are you talking about?
I mean, I feel like you know what I'm talking about when you're the first one to address it.
I'm saving us from the bad guys.
Uh-huh.
I'm doing my job.
Uh-huh.
Fine, then you guys can take on the next group of enemies and I'll just stay behind and eat rocks or something. Like a Goron does.
Also, while we're walking, guy just says, well, when did tech guy get here? I had...
Rova, how do you reply?
I just shake my head.
Yeah, that's cool. It's nice to see you. Wait, where'd Rova go?
I'm gonna lean in really close to him. I'm gonna say, I have a secret.
Yeah, tech guy.
I'm not tech guy. But don't tell anyone else, okay? It's just between you and me.
That's a lot of pressure.
I know, but that I'm trusting you, fellow Zora friend.
Wait.
No one else knows.
You're not a Zora. You're a human. What are you talking about?
All right. Marching order coming from the bottom left towards the bridge.
Please put me in the middle. Please put me in the middle.
Wait.
I'm going in the back.
So you guys staying are in coming the back. From, going... You guys are coming from here, like this way.
Okay.
Well, before the bridge, because you guys will encounter them before you get there.
I just kind of accidentally put them there.
Sure, it's an accident.
I don't want to be in front of everybody anymore, okay? Yeah.
No.
Well, somebody was making a comment about me doing things, so I'm going to step back and let you guys take care of it then.
Oh, I don't see a reason why we have to take care of this. I'm just running. Like,
this is also an option. They're not going to be able to follow you.
Yeah. Like,
yeah.
I don't know why the first thought was, let's kill the things. They can't follow us.
Unless we want to do some cool shield parries.
Why can I not do my thing?
You gotta drag from the name, not the picture.
Yeah.
There we go.
So are you guys just gonna book it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, they're going to roll to hit.
I guess they really only get one chance. I would like to use dodge as well.
Yeah, okay.
There we go.
I would assume so.
If we sprint like twice the move.
Yes, yeah.
I'm just gonna roll up into a ball and roll across this.
Because it also
increases my defense.
Do we have a token that looks like Inteka? Would be more accurate right now.
I don't think I made him a token because I wasn't expecting him to be on the battle map.
That's okay.
Imagine.
Imagination.
Yeah. Activating sprint consumes your standard action. What type of action is the shielding, the dodging?
So that's also a standard action.
Okay, so,
I'll be doing dodging instead of sprinting.
Okay.
I'm just going to double check the rules on that because I know it reduces somehow. I just don't remember how.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm going to roll up into a ball because that's a minor action.
Sure.
And I'm just going to roll across.
All right, you do so. And, so that way you can still be able to sick dodge as your standard.
Yeah, plus while I'm as in a ball, I resist all attacks by 4 ranks. Of course. Yes, I do. It's why I took the technique when I made the character.
Mm-hmm. That's their range, 12. They got some arm. They got some mouth.
Ew. Gross. I don't need to hear about weird. Them in their mouths. You nasty.
Oh, my goodness. All right. So.
Gross.
Their arc shot. Their normal shot is within 8. So someone will be able to get hit by a normal shot. They're both the same damage. One just takes up more stamina. Actually, it doesn't matter how much stamina it takes up. They're not going to be able to get multiple shots in.
Yeah.
But anyways, so it is 2 hit check. It's okay. That is one of their 2 hits. We'll say it's against, let's roll a d5 here. Guy.
Of course it is. Because why wouldn't it be?
Hey, the dice said so. So that's 8 damage.
Sorry, I'm still trying to find the rules for dodge because I think it actually modifies the hitting.
Okay.
Chance as well.
Yeah. So that was a 15 to hit.
It won't. I don't think it will hit actually based on the dodge rules, but I have to. Like I said, I gotta find that quickly. It's been a hot second. And I can't search through my PDF right now. And I'm not liking it.
I just used the homebrew wiki.
Can somebody send me the link to the homebrew wiki? I can't word!
Why? Wiki?
The blah! What?
So you're trying to do what again?
Dodge. I'm trying to dodge.
Is that the name of it?
Yeah.
You sure?
It's either dodge or guard.
You mean defend?
Defend. That's the one.
Okay. Defend. You are considered hard to hit until the start of your next turn. If you are wielding a defensive weapon, such as a shield, then your guard stats all increase by 1 until the start of your next turn as well.
Hard to hit, I think, is the rule that will add a bonus to my defense, if I remember correctly. Either that or the evasion stat.
What is hard to hit? It's hard to find, hard to hit.
It is.
Is it in combat?
That's where I thought it was.
Yeah, I don't see it under combat.
What on earth? What deal?
Oh, no,
that's what on earth is hard to hit me? Where
so it it's like a status effect.
Yeah.
It's a status effect.
Find those. Status effects. Here we gosh darn go. Hard to hit. Oh, there's hard to hit and there's hard to hit extremely.
Yeah. I don't have
extremely. Where is that? Under what?
I had to search for effects. It's under hazards and recovery.
That's where it is. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. While a foe is hard to hit, you suffer a -2 to all roll to hit and accuracy checks against them. So really, that is a 13 to hit.
Which will not hit me.
There you go.
Nice.
Defense, baby. That's why I use it.
Alrighty. The next one is a 13 to hit against. Let's roll another D5. Also guy.
Yeah, that seems right. It also won't hit because I'm in defense. Weird. All right, weird that somehow I always get aimed at. Odd.
16 to hit against. Against Rova this time.
I was going to say.
The other fish. They just don't like fish today.
Well, I don't look like a fish, though.
Oh. They just somehow smell it. I don't know.
I guess.
There's fish in these waters.
So that there is a 16 to hit you there, Rova.
Yeah.
8 damage.
Oh, I died. No. Not quite. That's pretty close, though.
I was going to say, if you said it, I would have like felt that in my soul.
I would have really made it. I bet.
And then lastly, a 12 to hit against Viridian.
I don't like that the dice kept on hovering around 3, by the way.
That's a miss.
Like, not a 1, not a 5.
It was either you or the people next to you.
Yeah. All right.
Also, I don't know what it means when it says that I resist all attacks by 4 ranks. I don't get what that means.
I feel like we had this discussion last time and we all forgot.
Probably.
Yeah. Doesn't matter anymore because I missed, so.
Yeah, whatever.
Alright, cool. Y'all got to see this cool map for a second. Wow.
Yay! We saw a map. Hooray.
Did you get any heroism tokens for that?
No. For running away like a bunch of cowards? No.
We narrowly dodged peril.
Weird. We didn't decide to kill things.
We found a unique situation, a solution to get around.
We left enemies on a known walking trail that could attack other passerbyers.
No, we're cutting through the mountains.
No, you're on the path at this point.
We are.
Yeah.
But it is also nighttime, so, like, people don't usually travel at night because of this kind of stuff.
Eh.
Well, why are we traveling at night? Whose idea is this?
All of ours. What do you mean?
It was so we could get to Zora City.
Well, I thought we were going to sleep for the night.
No, yes, but we are. You still had to spend 2.5 hours to get there.
Yeesh, keep up.
So you get there around like 10:30 or so. Right. Safe and sound. Completely unscathed. -1. But, you know,
I'm mostly dead, actually, but, you know, this is why I'm not in the front.
Can't you heal yourself or something?
No.
Oh, that sucks.
I can sleep.
Did somebody say heals? I can heal people.
I mean, sure.
But I'm not going to because we're in the city already. Like, you're fine. You can sleep.
I think 1 HP in this game is equivalent to, like, practically keeling over, and you're like, oh, you're fine. Just walk it off.
I mean, wait. Yeah, no, I'd heal you. If it's 1 HP, yeah.
No, I'm down. I just took 8.
Oh, so you're not at 1 HP.
Oh, I thought you were.
No, that's like half my health.
I mean,
if I got hit again, I might have died.
Yeah, you're fine.
Yeah.
All right. And with that, you guys reach Zora City.
Time to go find somewhere to sleep.
Yes, and you find somewhere to sleep. What do you guys each do?
First of all, I'm giving... everybody their secret handshakes as I'm walking through the city. Most people know me. I'm an influencer.
Do you have a secret handshake with Inteka?
Honestly, everybody, yeah.
Do you try to do Inteka's secret handshake with me? I just stare at you. I wouldn't know it.
Yeah, it happens. I get it, Inteka.
Awkward. I go to find food, and then I'm going to bed.
I'm just gonna go right to bed.
I am warily sticking close to everyone.
You guys can look on stream to see a picture of Zora City. Lots of ornate, classical-looking buildings made mostly out of glass and other blue
stones. Nothing looks like a fish, though.
What?
Because they're all in bed.
Not a lot of fish things.
No, but like if you look at Breath of the Wild and you look at the architecture of Zora's domain, like,
yeah, I guess so.
It looks like fish.
You know, that was a little bit harder to find images of.
I guess. Just saying, it's very unfish-like.
Maybe the overall layout of it comes to form the shape of a fish.
Okay, I'm fine with that.
Yeah.
Imagination. Yeah. There's something fishy about this place.
There's plenty of waterfalls. Even more waterfalls than before. As the like reservoir no longer quite is a reservoir. You know, that part of why, going back to the map, like there's this like just huge lake here is the like they kind of relocated themselves because they needed to get out of that canyon a bit because they were outgrowing it. So they relocated themselves. They went ahead and got rid of the dam, and you know, just the lake got bigger as a result.
Yes, flooding. Destroying the land as we go. Very sorry.
Yeah. Well, the dam also kind of gave way. Like was.
That's fair. You probably interrupted a bunch of stuff too.
Yeah. There's been a lot happening.
Honestly, place where there's a bunch of dams.
What's going to happen to the dam in Tears of the Kingdom? Oh my goodness.
Yes. I guess we'll find out on May 12th.
Yeah.
I could write a daily debate on that.
Yeah.
Anyways.
All right.
So, yeah.
I go up to one of my friend's doors and I knock
on it. All right. You do so. And, he's just who are you thinking?
I call this person brawfish. I don't know if they like it or not.
What fish?
Brawfish.
Brawfish?
No, bra. Like
brawfish.
Brawfish.
Yeah.
they probably don't like it. but.
It seems like nobody likes you.
Well, I mean, they kind of like me. They like me in the sense that I'm funny, but they don't like me in the sense that I keep on mooching off of them. But also, I'm like one of those people that it's hard to say no to, so it really helps out.
So you come up to one of them and greet them as brawfish, and they just reply,
What do you want this time?
Yeah, man, it's been a while. Brawfish. Brawfish. Handshake.
Roll.
Persuasion.
What?
Persuasion.
Persuasion, maybe. Either persuasion or
Or influence, I guess.
Or influence. There's not really a charm, is there?
No, I feel like influence is the closest one to that.
Yeah. So either of the ones you mentioned.
Nine.
Alrighty. And I guess I'll roll his, like, resistance of some sort.
Yo, why resist? Why resist?
Because why not? Average man. Oh, no, yeah. He'll give you the handshake. He'll go through with it.
Yeah. Yo, I know it's been a hot minute. Just back in town for a little bit, and I need a place to crash. Do you mind?
Mind is definitely the word that I would use.
Yo.
I don't really have a
place. I knew you'd totally understand. I walk in.
You're not eating any of my food.
Yo. Mi casa, you casa, yeah?
No.
Let me guess, you're already eating his food while you're saying that, right?
I mean, I saw a pear on, like, the table and started eating it.
Seriously, you touch any of that food, I'm kicking you out.
Oh. Come on.
Or pay for it.
Whoa, where's the hostility coming from, my man? What's this about?
Listen, I'll let you stay on the couch.
I mean, as always.
But if you want food, you have to earn it with money, right? Like everyone else.
I mean, of course, but you remember that time, right? You know, the time that, like, I went out and I helped advertise your business a little bit. I went around, chatted it up a little bit. Are we forgetting about that time?
If you do that again for me in the morning, then I'll give you some food, but not until then.
Oh. I mean, yeah, okay. Sounds good, my man. You know, I really appreciate you putting up the place. And then I, like, say, yeah, you guys can come in now. And I'm yelling to the rest of the party.
Yeah, the rest of them walk in. I guess Zelda is now back in her Hylian form. Yeah, she will come in and be like, if this... Will this cover it? And she, like, hands him 100 rupees.
Whoa.
Dang.
See? I walk in just loud and obnoxious while I'm eating, like, fish that I found from, like, a lake or whatever.
Hello, comrade. Thank you for letting us stay in house. Kind of tiny, but I'll make it work.
Wait, don't you sleep in a hole?
I can sleep anywhere.
At least give the guy the common courtesy of having a bigger place.
By Goron standards, it's probably tiny.
I'm just gonna kind of, like, hesitantly linger in the doorway, knowing that guy probably did not actually ask for us to stay.
Zelda's giving the money over, and it's like, this should probably cover today and anything that's happened in the past with him and future, hopefully.
Mi casa, you casa, and you see, by giving kindness, you receive kindness, my friend.
And to which he just looks around and is like,
The homeless people have multiplied.
I mean, well, already then.
You're never gonna, like, homeless when stay in the doorway until I get actual permission to come in from him, because I'm like, I'm not invading this man's house.
No, yeah, eventually, like, from those, you know, that generous little donation, he'll let you in. And okay. I think that's where we will take our break. Okay. And I think, Teus, that's where things get wrapped for you, right?
I mean, unless there's something you want me to do just beforehand, yeah.
We will after these three go off to break.
Okay.
Teus's character is just gonna bum here for the rest of the campaign.
This is my home for the rest of this campaign, ladies and gents. For those of you in the chat, this is my last session. So, it's kind of sad.
Yeah.
At the same time, I'll be able to come in as a guest once in a while, which is really nice.
Oh, he will. So it's not like it's his last session as a like primary protagonist, but it's not his last session that he'll exist.
Right. So
just got a lot of stuff going on, I'm assuming.
It's mostly just like I found out that my brain can't handle much past 2 hours at a time for most things.
So
like doing this for 4 hours is very taxing.
Fair enough.
But, you know, 2 hours? I can do 2 hours. So once in a while.
Yeah.
And, you know, that, and yeah, there are, like, there's other things that I'm trying to work on this summer, too, which are kind of secrets right now, but maybe I'll share them in the future.
Oh. Good to hear.
I'm gonna miss everybody.
Yeah,
even
dude.
I'm probably going to be popping into chat.
Good.
Then I could just passively be here and make fun of y'all, which would be great.
It's fair enough.
Much appreciated.
And then just randomly pop in out of nowhere into the game whenever you please.
Yeah. Honestly, sounds about right. Sounds very much like Guy. So.
Yeah.
Look. For every end, there's a new beginning, right? It's going to be good. It's going to be good. That's okay. It's just different. I think that's the best word for it. Y'all going to make me cry.
You've been in this from the beginning of PokeQuest, the first one of these.
I know. And I loved PokeQuest. I've loved this. But also, I did notice, like, I just felt like I was getting very exhausted by the end of sessions.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't want to bring anybody down. And that's, like, that's the last thing I want, because this is very special to me, you know?
Yeah. You don't want to oversalt the campaign.
Yeah, exactly. I don't want to be the salty person when this has been like when this has really meant a lot to me to be a part of this. Like the fact that you invited me into this has always meant a lot to me.
The fact that it means a lot to you means a lot to me.
Like, God damn it! I'm not gonna cry.
I wish we had webcams right now.
No.
Right.
No.
Yes. Yes.
Fine. It's fine.
Fine. We love you, Taz.
I appreciate you all. And I'll be around. I promise I'll be around. And I'll come in to interrupt things. Of course. And you know what? If anybody's ever like, I can't make it that day, I guess you have a backup player.
Just gonna take over their character.
I mean, who knows? Say.
You're gonna get me killed the moment you try that.
I'm not gonna lie, people have let me control their characters before and it's never been a good idea.
Nice.
So yeah.
Hey, what happened? The session I missed. Well, you're rolling up a new character.
I mean, there's been times when like somebody was one thing and then suddenly they were another thing and they came back and they were like, wait, what? I was like, who could say? Things happen.
Yeah. That's one way to put it.
Fine. Yeah. Things happen. I feel like I don't have anything like, I don't know. It feels weird to say like this is the last for me in this. Who knows? Maybe in the future it'll be easier for me to do 4 hours at a time. You never know. Maybe it'll change.
Maybe. Yeah. Oh, welcome in, Beowulf. How are you doing there, friend? Exenia. Alright, yeah. So if the rest of you guys want to hop out for just a smidgen while I do this with Teus.
Sure.
Okay. Get yourselves moved into that lobby. That sweet, sweet lobby over there.
Oh, that's right. They're in Discord. I can just boot them.
Yeah, just move them over. You're good.
Shmoop. There we go.
There you go.
Okay. You go to sleep that night. Congratulations.
I'm glad that I could sleep.
And as you sleep, you have a vision of this magenta light that kind of blinds you for a second. Then you see standing before you some kind of humanoid lady, like pretty much featureless, like just the silhouette of a lady in a dress. Completely magenta, and two white glowing eyes that seem like they are staring. Even though there's no pupils, they seem like they're staring directly at you.
I think that's too much of this spice again. Okay, this is one wicked dream. Gotta lay off the Garo spice.
You are Guy, are you not?
Whoa. You know, pretty knowledgeable for a figment of my imagination.
You are possessing one of the other fragments of what we had left behind.
Are you the goddesses?
I am one of three.
Oh, snap.
You behold what not many have seen. I am Din of the Triforce of Power. I'm the one that created that.
Oh. Hey. I know this is gonna sound really off tone. I would really appreciate making a secret handshake with you, though.
Roll influence.
You had to do it. Come on, baby. Roll high influence. Let's have a secret handshake with the goddess. 8. Not great. That was a low roll for me.
Yeah, what was that? A 3 and a 1. Yep.
Yep. Had better rolls.
In time, perhaps.
I get it. You have time. You're busy. I got you.
I don't usually get involved with the world created in general. Me and my sisters tried to be hands off. That's why we gave the Triforce, so that we wouldn't have to intervene. And it's also why we gave the Ark of Eshka that the current wielder of my piece of Triforce is trying to obtain.
Oh, snap. Okay.
I know that you currently wield a fragment of the Triforce of Courage, but what if you were to wield power instead?
Whoa. I mean, would I Didn't she say you already gave somebody?
I didn't give it per se. Demise stole it years ago and now resides in someone known as Ganondorf.
Okay.
I would like to no longer have my name tarnished by Demise and his reincarnations possessing this. And also, primarily, the Ark of Eshka needs to be destroyed.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, oh, that's a power. I mean, if it's gonna help, I just want to help, to be honest.
As of right now, that lies in someone else's hand, so it cannot be simply given to you by me. But are you willing to take this quest and become my disciple?
Yes. On. Can I ask for just one condition, though?
I'll hear you.
Can we please have a secret handshake once I complete this quest for you? Pretty please.
I accept.
Heck yeah. Alright. Yeah, I got this. I got you. Wait, does that... I guess that means I can't be with everybody else anymore, hey?
From time to time, you might... For now, I have some missions I need to send you on.
I get you.
Well, let's get started, shall we?
I'm assuming that I'm kind of in the, like, kind of hovel place. And everybody else is there, but not seeing what I'm seeing.
No, this isn't a dream. You're basically in the sacred realm, really.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, tell me where to go, and am I going to have a moment to say bye to all of them, or?
No. And then it cuts to black.
Okay.
And that, the music ended right just then. And that is where we end your session.
Okay. Bye, everybody.
Thank you for being here, Deus.
Oh, thank you, Fedora. Oh. Okay.
Man.
I'm going to miss this.
You better.
I will. All right. Y'all, don't kill them, please. Fedora, don't kill them. Say it. Don't kill the peeps.
No promises.
Fair. Okay. All right. Okay. I feel like I'm really bad at saying goodbyes, so I really appreciate this. I'm gonna go. Bye.
Bye, I love you. Love
you. Oh, what a dude, what a guy. Boop 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 boop.
All right, now we are officially on break. All righty. Wow. Yo, welcome back, Alex. Confirmed theory that Rova's the real murderer. Nothing's been confirmed or denied in that sense. Also, you're not the only one that has come up with that theory. I'd like to note there, Alex. There's. Which I love. I love when you guys come up with cool theories around this content. It's good stuff. But yeah. Here's the thing. Since we don't have webcams, I cannot tell who's back and who's not.
I'm here.
Hi, here. I'm Will.
I'm
In Tech is here. I don't know about everyone else.
All right, I'm back. What'd I miss?
You know, stuff that you're not going to know about until later.
Cool.
Cool.
So I guess Rova murdered Teus.
Yep. Something like
cool.
that. Teus, did you make one? Did you make a one of the things for Solid's character? If you're still there. Because if not, he's about to need that. But yeah, let's see here. We're gonna now. Oh, perfect, perfect. Awesome. All righty. All righty. Cool, cool, cool. So, oh, yeah. So, what the? Oh, that's fair. Okay. So, yeah, how's everyone doing? How's everything been so far for all y'all?
Are you asking us or chat?
Both? I don't know.
Fine. It's been fine.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
No, I'm having fun.
Good, yeah.
I'm chilling.
Vibing. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We do.
Yes, indeed. Alrighty. So, you guys, let's see here. Let's jump back in actually. If y'all are good for that.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. So you guys wake up the next day in Zora City and you find a distinct lack of Gyarados.
Why is it so quiet? It's crazy.
And the guy that you were like kind of crashing on is like,
Where'd Guy go?
He probably got drunk. And
I didn't know he was a drinker.
Ended up in an alley somewhere. Well, I didn't either, but you know. Here we are.
I don't think. Did he? He better not have taken any of my food. He goes into the kitchen to make sure that, like, you know, everything is there. Meanwhile, Zelda comes in to the room with like severe bedhead and is like,
"Where's Guy at?"
Guy, wake up!
You guys then, like, you know, you can't find him anywhere. You start searching around town, asking around even. No one's able to just to find him.
Has anyone seen a Zora?
And then ultimately, Zelda gets out a, like, opens up a special app on hers, on her Sheikah slate that you guys don't have. And it's like shows a map of the place, and you guys can see little small yellow triangles on the map that y'all go ahead and roll. Let's see. What was technology again? That was mechanics. Let's go with mechanics or insight. All right, 13 on insight. All right, Zanzi, you're able to figure out, like, oh, this is tracking where we are.
Oh, okay.
I think, don't ask me how I know. I think that he's already in the Republic of Terry.
How do you know where he is?
The same way that you were found originally.
And how was that?
They're tracking us.
We're able
to... They're doing what now?
We know where the fragments of the Triforce are.
My character AKA, starts like...
They're tracking us.
My character starts saying a lot of bad words in Russian.
We're not tracking you. We're tracking the fragments of the Triforce.
But they are in us.
Why haven't you told us this before? What else?
Because it wasn't relevant? When would it have come up?
This is big invasion of privacy.
How?
Do you understand the danger?
I thought it was implicit at that point. Like how, you know, us finding you in these remote locations, even though, you know, you're... There's no way to like, know... You know, wasn't it a little uncanny that we just kind of knew you had the fragment of the Triforce in you?
It was uncanny. But that's besides the point. You realize what could happen if one of the enemies got a hold of your Sheikah Slate?
We know. There's not many of these, and we keep them under locks. No.
Well, yeah, but you have one with you.
So you need to make sure no one knows about this feature on here, okay?
Yeah, well, if you had told us, we would have been...
I wasn't going to tell you, and then you started asking questions, okay?
Well, you should have... Yeah,
listen, I'm sorry.
Trust is a two-way street.
You're right, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
You have to, you know, we have to trust each other. We have to share all of our deepest, darkest secrets, just like how I just shared my deep, dark secrets. So, you know. That's what we're gonna do going forward. Anyone else got dark secrets? Anyone going once?
I'm just gonna walk out.
Going twice?
Just my dad.
Right, good talk.
I look at Zelda and I'm like, and I thought I could trust you. And then I start walking away.
I'm sorry.
So you guys, we're going to jump cut to you guys finding this spot within the Republic of Terry. You find this wall that basically spent a whole day getting to this point. All just because like you really can't progress without him, so yeah. But though you find this wall with these like blocks of stone that have like these carvings in them that seem to have something to do with like music notation, for those that know what that is. I mean, y'all roll civ and let's see how much about music you know. Or perform. Civ or perform. All right, Zanzi knows that it's music notation. And no one else does. Zelda does. Because
what are pretty marks?
What are the scribbles on wall?
Oh, that's music notation.
And you see and standing in front of it some kind of small furry winged creature. And it's at this point, go ahead and turn around. Turn around.
Unloaded. No.
Wait for it to load. There we go.
He was raised by Woodchuck and Woodchucks. It's solid state. Woo! Yay! Hey, welcome in our new player, Solid State, and let's get you in the Discord here, friend. We're not.
We ended up not being able to use the Video Ninja. Oh, hello?
Oh, it's so loud.
Loud.
Hi, Solid.
Hello, I need to turn all of you down. I guess my Discord's all messed up.
All righty. Yes, welcome in. Wrong one there. Come on. Yes, welcome in. Oh, I need to bring your group thing in. Add group, assisting. That
fun
one.
Fun stuff.
And then just overlay you. There we go. Alrighty. So oh crap. I need to add you though. Because now we're using this instead. I didn't think this far ahead.
Nice.
Yeah, this is just a today thing. Once I get the new computer, which I guess is now going to actually be a PC, then this won't matter.
I mean, they don't know my name. They don't need to read it on the UI. Sure.
That's true. Well, no, I mean, we need your little just something to represent your face.
Oh, okay, perfect.
Love there we go. It.
That's a taxidermied coyote from a nearby store.
That is
love it.
Terrifying, but okay.
But yet it fits so well.
Yeah. Right?
So we sure see a flying that. Thing.
Okay.
I'm attempt to shoot it.
Hold on.
No.
I get my bow ready.
All right. So what you guys see is actually this on screen here. You've never seen this species before, and I want all of you guys to roll civilization with disadvantage.
You know I'm not going to get this anyway.
Yeah.
That's the point.
So what, it's 2d6 and
just,
take the
just
lowest
roll
number?
It twice and take the lower.
Roll it twice.
Okay.
You know, I did pretty average.
Dang.
Zanzi knows one. Exactly what this is.
Zanzi knows of. As okay. You don't know what Zanzi knows yet. So, you guys
how high in the sky is this?
Not. This is at the base of the cliff.
Oh, I was going to shoot it.
So what do you Solid, go ahead and take control of your character. What are you up to?
Okay, do I see everyone? Like, what do I see?
Right now, roll perception to see if you even notice them.
Wow, that's gonna be a good one.
Yeah, you notice them. You notice them.
I didn't think that was gonna be, I looked at my perception of one and said, well.
What?
Okay, so I see a group. What do you mean, what?
You had one was your perception? Oh my goodness.
Do you know what? Most of my skills are one.
What do you have?
That's classified. I'm just gonna turn around and I see these people approaching me. Someone mentioned a gun.
No, I said a bow. I'm gonna shoot you with a bow.
I was like, where'd you get that? Are you pointing that at me right now?
Are you in the air right now?
Will, am I supposed to click that link you sent me?
Yeah, and then use the two images that Teus just gave you and upload those there.
I have to log in? Oh, man.
Yeah, you have to do stuff. Sucks, right? All because Will didn't have a good computer.
I don't know my password.
To your Discord?
I don't think so.
Oh, well, it's just going to be a taxidermy coyote.
No, wait, hold on. It's asking me for two-factor authentication. I'm going to read it out loud so everyone knows what it is.
Okay. Sounds good.
No, I just have to remember what two-factor authentication app I use.
It'll probably just be the Discord app, right?
99999.
Mm.
authorized. Set inactive image, set speed. Oh man, I didn't go to school for this. Oh no.
Speaking okay. of nine.
Save image, desktop.
Starting now.
You called me, like I just had a big dinner and I'm like brain dead. And now you're asking me to do this.
You're brain dead. We've been at, no! Who did that?
No, yeah, so the timer's already going.
I hate it here. Who did that? I can't see the chat. Who did it?
Viridian.
Viridian! I will end you.
Why did that
You've
one save
the... You've got to find me first.
Why did that one save the downloads and the other one saved my desktop?
But you will not find me.
I will just ask comedian where you are.
He doesn't know where I am.
Well, we can figure it out.
Okay, I think I have it. What do I do?
You're good.
Like it's working?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
First try.
Awesome.
Neat. So okay. Yes, are you flying?
I am not flying. I can't do that. Those are not very large wings.
Okay, so if he's not flying, then I'm not pointing my bow at him.
Will I assume I'm just standing in front of this wall, like trying to figure it out?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking at this thing and I hear some people show up and I turn around. I'm just like, I just wave at them with a giant goofy smile like, hey guys, are you adventurers like too?
What are you?
I'm going to stop and back away just a little.
I cast Girahams. I mean, I wave.
What do you mean? What am I? Oh, you guys haven't seen. Oh, okay.
Nine.
Well, what am I? I forgot.
What race am I again?
No, I think you just leave it at that. That's your character doesn't know what he is.
God, what am I?
Your character doesn't even know what they are.
I forgot the name of the species in it. It says insert race here in my backstory because Will didn't have it done by the time I wrote my backstory.
Nice.
I'm pulling it up.
Are you like a reptile kind of thing, but you have wings?
I think I'm like a bat.
Correct. Bat dragon.
I have seen bats. You are no bat.
Chirovern.
I'm a Chirovern. You know. Chirovern.
I do not know.
Well that's
Zanzi sure recognizes that name as like barely anyone has seen one. They used Zanzi, you know that they used to live underground until the red moons, the blood moon stopped and the monsters went underground and the Chiyoverns got kind of drove above ground, but they still live in secret and they're only known because they're some of the greatest craftspeople in the world.
Huh, neat.
Pretty sure I had a cousin named Chiyovern, but you know.
Wow, that's weird. I had a cousin named whatever you are. I'm sorry, I lied. I don't do that. I don't know. I think I'm stressed. I've never, you guys kind of showed up just like right behind me. That's fun. That's cool.
I just turn around back to the others and I start going, cuckoo.
Anyways, it was nice meeting you. Let's go.
Wait. Can you help me solve this puzzle? This thing's really messing with me.
Nine. We have other things to do than help you solve some stupid puzzle.
Okay, well, that's sad for you.
I do like puzzles, but like, let's make it quick.
I mean, I thought you guys were adventurers.
Zelda. Zelda speaks
you
up.
You assume incorrectly.
It's she, I think he's a, he, there's no one else around, but this is where the, can I see your hand?
Pointing to you.
Yeah, and I hold out my hand with the glove on.
She walks up and just without asking first starts taking off the glove.
Yeah, I just let it happen.
All right. And
just not even
gonna be an interesting character.
And sees and that's when the little Triforce very much the same piece that was highlighted on Guy's arm or Guy's hand is highlighted here.
Gasp!
I look at that and hold it up to my face and I'm like, did you put that there?
You killed Guy.
I don't think I've ever killed a guy.
Did you eat him?
But wait, does that imply that you've killed girls?
I've never eaten a person. I feel like I'm being asked a lot of really sensitive questions.
Our friend disappears and now you have something of his.
What, a tri- this thing?
How Where did you get that get from?
It? Yeah, the triangle.
Well, I mean, I think rashes are just like more than one person could have a rash.
Not this kind of rash.
I pull out my sledgehammer.
I prepare my Gurahem's dagger spell.
Now wait. That won't solve the puzzle. Trust me. Frustration and violence never solves puzzles.
How do
I guess we'll find
have,
out. You don't know until we try.
How do you have our friend's piece of the Triforce?
I don't know. She just put it on my hand. Do I know who Zelda is?
No.
Okay. That lady just put it on my hand.
I'm just gonna look at Zelda and just go, what is going on?
I listen. This does not bode well about the state of Guy. He might no longer be with us.
So this thing killed Guy is what you are
That's
saying.
What I was saying.
We don't know. It could have been that, I don't know. It doesn't make sense. Like this took a whole day to get here. And according to the map, this person, what was your name again?
My name is Arbit.
Arbit? Arbit?
Arbit.
Arbit.
With a B.
Arbit.
I think.
Okay. Arbit didn't move at all today and has been at this spot the whole day.
Correct. I stayed the night here.
Well, I know is that by the end of it, they are going to be little bits if they don't tell us why he has that.
I have a question for Zelda. What happens if one of us with the Triforce dies? Does the person who killed them get it? Or does it go to someone random?
I doubt it goes to the person that killed them unless they have some kind of means of getting... I don't... It's weird.
Would it go to someone else who has the qualifications?
It most likely would.
So what happened to Guy?
You're saying that this thing has qualifications.
You guys, I can prove it. Just cast your surface dwelling truth telling spells on me.
What in the world are
you all have? You all
about?
Have that, right?
Surface. I've never heard of anybody having that.
Oh, well, that was probably just one bad encounter then. You know, that's how bias starts.
This is a waste of time. I want to find Guy. Or at least what happened.
You know what I think is that we shouldn't linger in Zora territory any longer than we need to.
We're not.
Yeah, we're in Terry.
We're in the Republic of Terry. We're not in Zora's domain.
But we're near Zora places.
This is true.
I don't like hanging around.
Yeah, and we need to go talk to King Zora anyway.
I don't want to touch it. Yeah, I know. That's why we should get what we need from the Zoras and get out. Because the longer we stay here, the higher the chances are that something bad might happen with, you know.
But do we take this thing with us?
No.
We have to.
Why?
Because who else has... There's only one of this specific piece, and we need all the pieces.
We don't even know if Guy's dead or not.
Correct. And, well, he most likely is, but that's not important. It actually is, but what you listen.
This is a waste of time. I'm just gonna start walking away angrily.
I mean, you could just like kill me.
Okay. I take out my hammer.
No! She like jumps in front of him.
Move aside, little girl.
Listen, just because Guy probably died doesn't mean that he has to too.
Okay, everyone. Let's calm down.
I kinda like push Zelda to the side a little bit and go, sorry, I realize that came off as a threat. It wasn't. Just trying to work cooperatively.
Alright, my little winged friend, I have a question for you. Do you have the courage and fortitude to follow orders and stay true in the face of danger in almost certain death? Yes or no?
I mean, probably.
Okay.
Life really is just one big interview, isn't it?
Sure. I trust him completely.
Okay. Anyone else have any questions or concerns?
I'm still just walking. I
raise my hand.
Yes.
Can I have some help with this puzzle? I solved it, but it's not solved.
Okay, what's the puzzle?
Music.
Oh.
Nope. Not my forte.
So the blocks. There are these like these like cubic blocks that like have these engravings on them. The way he has it arranged now, you can kind of tell. Well, roll intuition. Actually, I should say before I assume.
Me or.
Definitely not you.
I've already intuited.
Insight, I should say.
Who should roll that?
Anyone that is willing to look at this puzzle.
I will look. Sorry, insight?
Oh, yeah. My insights are really high. You didn't
I'm like
roll.
40 feet away, and I just turn around, and I just sit on the ground angrily.
Okay.
Just
I rolled things.
All right, Rova is able to tell that... You couldn't tell what a musical note was earlier.
No.
Well, I've had an enlightenment.
Oh well, you can tell that like there are these lines that are not presently parallel. That like some of the blocks, if you just simply turn them, will be parallel.
I think we should do it like this, and I start turning a couple.
I would like to turn them so that they are parallel.
You do so, and those that rolled well earlier for their music insight recognize that once arranged, it displays like the musical note B in standard notation.
So what does this mean?
Well, that's a musical note.
Maybe what does it mean?
Well, maybe we need to get our slates out. Oh, we need to get we need to get a new slate for Arbit.
I can just pretend.
I don't think you can.
I think I can.
Well, you're the princess. You can figure that out.
Here, I'm going to... Here, let me just open this... Where'd it go? There it is. I'm opening up... Here, I'm going to just play for us which one's B? So that one's C, D, E. It's just a break between... So that's... Is this B?
And at which point, suddenly the like seams between the blocks seem to like just kind of like glow a bit, and it becomes one solid block. And then it crumbles away, and there is a beehive left behind and a bunch of angry bees that are now coming at you guys.
Ugh.
I roll up in a ball and I start rolling the heck out of there.
I found it! Bees!
I... Not the bees.
Not the bees!
Well, I cast Zol's Fireball on the beehive, I guess.
On the hive or the bees?
Probably yeah, on the bees.
On the bees.
That makes more sense. All right, and that automatically hits. How much damage?
A bunch of damage.
Too much damage. Weapon, willpower. Oh, my willpower went up since last. Weapon, 7. 14.
Nice. Oh, yeah, you took them all out.
I incinerate the bees.
Okay, I unroll from a ball and start coming back.
That was way better than any plan I had. I hate things that fly.
But you have wings.
Yeah, so do penguins.
I can't fly.
What does a penguin?
Well, you see, there was this book I read as a kid. It's called Happy Feet, and it was crazy.
What? Why
it was
were
about
you
a flightless bird?
Why were you reading a book about a bird that had happy feet? Why were his feet so happy?
It's a what long story. What made I'll the tell feet it to happy? You on the way.
Was it because of the feet that you read it? Is there something about feet that I need to know about you?
No, it was a bedtime story that my father used to read.
The entirety of Happy Feet every night before bed.
He used to inspire us to follow our dreams.
He read to you the script of an hour and a half long movie.
He wanted us to
every night.
He wanted us to follow our dreams and be ourselves no matter what. And
exterior, Antarctica.
And so my sister took that very literally and became a murderous... yeah, anyways.
Maybe you shouldn't be reading things about happy feet.
Well, look how I turned out.
I just look her up and down. I'm like, exactly my point.
Oof.
Listen. Were you just after this honey?
We can say that. I go up and I just cut I'm gonna like snap the whole hive off at the like anchoring point. Assuming it's one of those hives.
Sure.
And just like carry it over is anyone hungry? I could cook us something.
You know how to cook?
What? I literally have a pan strapped to my side.
None of us know how to cook.
I have a ladle and a pan.
We've been eating raw fish for weeks.
That's embarrassing.
Speak for yourself. I've been eating delicious rocks.
Tommy girl, welcome in. You doing? Oh, you found a slouch beanie. Nice. Yeah, everyone, don't forget about collecting your daily hat. Got it.
All right, little guy. If you want to earn your spot in our group, then cook us something good.
Okay, I would do that anyways.
Yeah, I'll give you some spices to help spice the food up.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sure. I can't do anything 5-star because this pan, I used it as a shield once. And it hasn't been the same since. But I can do my best.
You might not want to cook with that. That's Goron spice.
It's fine. It is edible. Nobody's ever died from it.
But you shouldn't apply heat to it.
You can apply anything to it.
Do you know what Goron spice is, Arbit?
Do I? Do I roll for it?
You roll sieve.
Can I roll cooking?
No.
Oh.
It is not actually a cooking thing.
Actually, average. Spices are a cooking thing. What are you talking about?
It's gunpowder.
No, it's not.
That was a 7.
Isn't it not gunpowder?
No, it's an actual spice used for cooking. It has ingredients.
I thought this whole time that you've been trying to sell gunpowder.
No, it's literally a cooking spice in the game.
Will literally told me you were selling gunpowder out of the game before I started.
Wow. No, it's a cooking spice.
Oh my god.
It is.
We're going to still say that Zelda thought that this was gunpowder.
I just looked it up. It says an initial wave of spiciness paves the way for the sweetness.
Exactly. It's like, it's a spicy but yet sweet-ish spice.
I thought
used for cooking.
I thought this was like the Goron special crop, the bombs.
No! The bombing and stuff, they use that in the mines. I don't do mining. I haven't done mining work in like forever. I've been making my own specialty spice for cooking.
Zelda is just like, her mind is blown. She's just like doubting everything that she believed.
What did you think I was making?
Bombs, I don't know.
If I were making bombs, little girl, then you would have seen me with a giant bag of bombs.
You do! You always have had bombs!
You know, these were bombs that I brought with me. And
I
then
thought they
were
from your company!
My company makes... My company is a Goron spice company.
This is like that SpongeBob episode with the exploding pies.
No! We don't make explosives. We make spices for cooking food.
You know, this explains why earlier Will was like, well, you can just craft bombs. It makes so much sense now.
I'm just going to walk over while this is all going on. Just like, I really hope we're arguing about what we're going to do about that thing and not anything else.
Apparently, Zelda thought that I was making, what did you say, gunpowder?
Yeah.
I don't know where she got that weird idea from.
Listen, I was wrong. We're going to move on.
I have been trying to take over the Goron spice market because current Goron spice does not have enough kick to it when you cook with it. So I have been making my own version of it, which has been very successful, as you see in my company. And you thought I was making explosives.
This whole time, Arbit has been cooking over a lantern with a pot. And Will, can I rule that no one's been paying attention?
No, yeah, go ahead.
Okay. I'm just going to say that I'm finished. And I'm going to look up and say, everyone, it's ready. And you are all served a plate. Will, I look this up. I can make this with the ingredients on hand. This is just juicing it. I still have all the like actual numbers and everything.
Oh yeah.
So you are all served what appears to be some sort of pancake with honey on it, and then like grilled honeycomb on the side with just a pinch of the Goron spice.
Thank you for that redemption.
What?
I was talking to Dom.
Oh, and I'll let everyone know that is a rank 1 that gives you +1 perception for the next until the next long rest, and cool. It heals 9 health.
Cool. Oh, this is very tasty. I like it.
Can I ask everyone else to make a check to see what it's made of?
I eat rocks,
for them,
man.
To be able to discern what it's made of?
Yeah.
Sure. No, yeah. That would be either cooking or perception.
If anybody wants to think about it. Yeah, that's probably good enough.
The 11s probably are good enough. What is it?
I would say, okay. So you would have definitely noticed if you had chosen to bite into the honeycomb or inspect it further, there's larvae in there. there is still larva in there, and in fact, the pancakes themselves, you don't know where the flour came from, but the bees are gone.
I haven't touched it yet, and I'm just sitting here staring at it.
But it's good.
Kogoro's already like halfway done scarfing the plate.
It's good. It's good food. Nice. Expand your horizons. You have to trust me.
Are those things alive?
No, not anymore.
The textures. Wait, what?
Bees?
I'm just gonna push my plate towards Kogoro.
He gladly takes your plate and starts eating it.
I think I still have some food in my pack. Let me check. Yeah, I still have some just like regular food in my pack.
See, because you can grind down bees into a flour, and that's what I made the pancakes with. And then larva is just a good source of protein, and it actually tastes pretty good if you grill it directly in the honeycomb.
Yeah, see, Kogoro eats rocks and metal and stuff like that. His stomach, like, he's probably eaten a
few worms.
Yeah, he does not care.
Just on a hunky day.
Kogoro finds this to be like the best meal he's had in like forever, because all he eats are rocks and minerals and stuff. So he's enjoying the heck out of this.
It is a rank one meal, which that's the best I can do with my current tools. I could do better if I had a better pan, but so that's what I'd say. That's the equivalent of like juiced up ramen made late at night that turned out better than expected.
Well, my friend, you certainly have interesting taste in.
I eat all of my food. I eat all of Rose's food. I look over Rova and I'm like, are you going to finish that?
I ate some of it, but yeah, you can have the rest.
Zelda picks up her fork, goes to try it again, and then like gets an eyes, like sees the larva, puts it back down, and just tries to like kind of like hide, like not look directly at it as she's like just kind of like scooping out the larva from it and then trying to eat around those.
So I eat all of Rova's food by now. I look over at Zelda. Are you going to finish that?
No.
Okay. I just take the plate.
I just take the plate.
I'd be happy to cook whatever you guys want if you can find ingredients.
Can you make something with rock?
Salt is rock.
I mean, yes.
Can you make fish?
I can definitely make fish.
So how do we get you better equipment for
cooking? All right, you're hired.
Money? Probably.
He's coming with us?
He makes good food.
We don't even know who he is!
He makes good food.
It doesn't matter!
But he makes good food.
I hold up my hand and point to him and go, I'm a part of the triangle.
We didn't know who each other were when we first met, but we placed our trust in one another. And look where we are now.
Yeah, I didn't have a choice. I was chained.
So was I.
Well,
yeah, y'all got to eat bees for the first time, so it must have worked out.
But it worked out for the best, didn't it?
I'm just gonna get up and like go towards the cliffside and just like steam.
I was gonna say.
What?
What are you doing near the cliffside there? Yeah.
I'm not gonna fall off the cliffside. I'm just like doing the thing where you're like sitting towards the edge, but not actually off of it.
Okay, I'm gonna.
I'm like 5 feet away from the edge. I'll be fine.
I'm gonna walk over to Zanzi. I'm gonna put my hand on her shoulder and say, "Do we need to have a talk?"
I'm gonna like shrug Rova off and just not look at her.
Is there something we need to talk about?
No, everything's fine.
Because it's okay. I know what it's like when you get to this stage of life.
Stage of life.
And, I'm just going to slowly, like, look at her and, like, start standing and just be like, what stage of life?
You know, when you get to a certain age, you start to experience changes.
Oh, you're going to get punched in the face.
But, you know, I just want you to know that we're, you know, it's okay. Because we're all together. And
I'm just going to start walking in any direction, whichever one suits me.
And hey, that's what I was trying to get us to do. Let's go.
Hoist up my stuff and I just start following.
All right, we march.
By the time you guys get back to Zora City, it is once again night. Of yet another day. Cool. So you guys find another place to, well, it's, no, that doesn't math right. It would be like it, you still have some time of the, in the day. It is probably around like 5.
We should go talk to the king. For it's,
hey, I agree.
I'm
speak to him.
I'm all for expanding horizons. I mean, that's why I'm here. But what are we doing?
We are going to talk to the king of the Zora, so that way there he can open up an entrance to get us into the Temple of Wisdom, so we can do a trial.
We went from having 2 Zoras to now we have no Zoras that can talk to the king.
We have Zelda.
Yes, I'm a princess.
Okay. Well, you do the
You're a princess?
Listen.
Yes, and I'm an outlaw, but we don't talk about that.
Wow, I'm beating so many. My uncle was an outlaw.
Yes.
That one's
so
the truth.
My cousin, and so was my cousin. But that's besides the point.
Let's go. I look at Arbit, and I'm like, if I can find you better cooking stuff, you can make better food. Yes.
Yeah, more ingredients.
I start, instead of going to the king, I instantly go to find a shop to look for like pots and pans.
All right.
Okay. We gotta go to the king, but I don't think I'm the one to be talking to the king.
As you start heading off, Zelda rushes up to you. He's like, no. It's we're running out of daylight. Come on.
It's only like what, 5 in the afternoon. We're fine. It doesn't get dark out until like 7:30, 8 o'clock anyway.
Listen, it's...
Okay, bye.
My Gron friend, we have priorities. We gotta stay on schedule here. We can't be lingering in Zora for too long.
But I wanted to go get our new companion some cooking utensils.
We can do that after we talk to the king.
I can talk to the king.
What if the king wants us to cook something?
I'm not burdened by the expectations of your society.
Alrighty then.
Okay, fine. Let's go talk to the king.
Alrighty. So you guys head in to the throne room of the king, and let me put up the picture of him. There you go. He is he's one of the youngest Zora kings that's been had for like eons. He's like fresh on the scene, essentially. He's only been a king for maybe like 2 years.
So I don't even know him.
No, you know him.
Last kinda, time I knew him,
he would have been the prince before that,
right? He
would have
been the prince, okay.
Yeah.
He's kind of funky fresh with the youth.
you walk up to him, he's like, yo, what's up? Welcome.
He gives me Gyarados vibes. I don't know if that's any
Z,
of you.
Hey, how you doing?
I think this is his brother.
King.
Could you imagine if it was?
King Larius. Hi. Hey, it's my old girl. How you doing? Oh, it's been forever. Remember back when we used to hit it? Well, she's so cute like that.
What kind of stuff did you use to do,
so
princess?
So it's not just Link who has a thing for... Okay, anyways.
I start getting very suspicious of what's going on.
Listen, Larry. Yeah, what's up? You know why we're here, right? Oh, I forgot! Yo, is it the, is that why you brought these homeless people with you?
I am not homeless. I own my own spice company. Thank you very much.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. So you brought... So who are these people then if they ain't homeless? Well,
the others are homeless.
Yeah, the rest of them are. But that's not the important part. Wait, are you homeless?
You're pointing to Arbit.
Yeah, technically. I have a home I can go back to, but I don't.
Then,
not for backstory reasons, but because I want an adventure.
Then he doesn't count then. He's not homeless. Look, these are the amazing, honorable heroes that are wielding the Triforce of Courage.
While she's saying honorable and stuff, my guy's like picking his nose.
Can a Goron's finger fit up their nose?
Yes.
Probably.
I'm just gonna glare between Zelda and the prince.
I'm just hiding behind Goro right now. I'm not taking any chances.
They're safe. They've already completed the Temple of Courage, actually, and they're here to take the trial of the Temple of Wisdom.
I thought it was power that we went to.
Oh, yes, the power one. Yeah, sorry.
I see. Well, tell you what. I didn't prepare for there being four of them. I thought there was just going to be one. Whoopsies.
Yeah, it came to a shock to us, too.
I thought that someone from the Sheikah should have told you about this. Yep, probably. Listen, Larry. Yeah, what's up? So do you have a trial for them or not?
Yo, Rora, hey, Rora,
and then out comes this.
I don't have the art. I'll have the art next week.
Out comes this very. Wait, did I come up with the art? Hold on.
Rova's sister or something?
I do have the art. No.
That'd have been interesting.
I hope not.
There we go.
That'd have been very interesting as a plot twist.
Very beautiful fish lady comes out.
Yes, father.
Hey, Hora,
I'm just looking in utter shock right now because he looks like he's only like, what, 20?
This is how the Zords work.
We have something for these kiddos to do, right, for the trial.
I thought Link took the trial already. Who are these people?
These are the new Link, right? This is Link. And this is Link, and this is also Link, and that's Link.
We're I'm Arbit.
Links. In the
They don't look like him. What happened? I thought that Link died. Yeah. These are the new Links. There's oh my goodness.
We are just as confused.
It's
maybe even more so.
Well, you see, I don't think we have anything prepared for them, Father, because, well, I don't know, dude. We might need some time to come up with that.
Can't you just give us the thing saying that we did a thing and we can be on our way?
that wouldn't be fun. And that would ruin the vibes, man. It's all about the vibes and the style and grooving.
Okay.
Xanthi is going to get, like, visibly angry when he starts saying vibes just because she hates that word.
I understood about maybe two or three words, little fishman, but we have things to do. So if you don't have anything for us, we might as well go to the next place.
Listen. I wasn't king when Link took the trial. I don't. What did he do? Well, he had to conquer the beast over on Crab Rock.
Okay, so then that is where we will go.
Well, the beast's already been conquered, so there's nothing there.
When was the last time you checked? That something may or may not be there.
Oh.
So how do you know nothing is there?
We know that Link took care of it, so it's not like it would just come back and multiply. That'd be stupid.
But could it? These are questions that must be answered.
Well, we would have heard about that by now. My lord.
A random soldier comes in.
Oh, I see where this is going.
This guard here.
Oh, hey, guard dude. Hey, what's up? She don't let your guard down.
Oh my gosh.
Is he related to guide?
He must be related to Guy.
He's got to be related to Guy.
There's no way he's not.
Well, you see,
I think everyone here is related to Guy, but...
Would that mean you're related to Guy?
I don't like to think about that.
The beasts of Crab Rock are... there were reports that they are back. We've just heard that one of our own was swallowed up by one of the beasts, and there are now four of them.
I told you so.
Wait. Did you just say swallowed?
Yes.
How big? What does it look like?
Big enough to... I've not seen one myself. I don't know. But apparently big enough to swallow Azora.
Okay.
Is it a crab?
It moves like one.
Oh, well, I guess that's why it's called Crab Rock.
No, it's called Crab Rock because the pools of water at high tide make a...
That sounds like the second most important thing on that island.
What, the water pools?
Yeah, there's kind of a big crab thing there. You want us to do something about that?
Yes!
Okay, so if we do that, then we complete trial, yes?
Yes. Probably.
No, Daddy, Father, I thought you were going to have them
find me a suitable spouse. I thought that was what we were going to have to do, is go.
Well, we could have them split up.
Why?
We either have to fight monsters that can swallow us whole or play matchmaker.
I'm fighting the monster.
I vote monster.
Can the monster be eaten? Let's find out.
Too bad Guy's not here. We could hand him over.
Well,
Guy is spouse material.
All right, let's go to Crab Rock. Where is it, Soldier Fishman?
The guard that came up now is like look like just kind of like perks up, like, you know, chest out just a little bit, and like hand one hand on hip, the other hand on his, actually exactly like this image here actually. and it's like,
well, I know the way, and I'll help you defeat this. The monsters of Crab Rock.
No offense, Fishman, but your arms look a little scrawny, so I think you'd be best to just show us where to go and we'll take care of it.
He hides his arms behind his back.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I think he should go with you.
Are you not coming, Zanzi?
I thought we were splitting up, and you two chose monster. Who else is gonna do matchmaker?
I'll be brutally honest. I never pinned you for somebody to do matchmaking.
Why can't this guy do the matchmaking?
Zelda, you stay and do matchmaking.
Can I be a part of both?
The guard says.
I think we would be better off if we took our best fighters to go fight these monsters.
Go fight monsters, then we come back and we can play matchmaker later.
You know, I agree. And I'll help you guys defeat that monster. By the way, you look very nice today, princess.
Referring to the to the Zora princess.
Well, I think our work here is done.
You mean him, her? Oh, I get it now. He likes the princess.
The princess looks up and is like,
Oh, okay, thank you.
And then just kind of goes back to just looking at her nails.
We did it.
But this.
Let's go do the other thing.
Yeah, we found the princess, her match, or whatever. So now we can go fight monster.
We're going to use him as bait.
Even better.
Whoa.
You know what they say. You can either die a hero or live long enough to become monster food.
No matter what, you die.
And this is why you're bait.
Father, that one's fluffy. What is he?
Hey, what are you, kid?
You don't have to answer that.
I'm a person.
He's monster.
He's a person go. There, honey.
I
pat him on the head.
Okay. Good enough for me. Do you think that person's variable?
He's just just completely not processing it.
Could we be losing Arbit real soon?
I mean, it's either he marries a princess or he's monster food. Either way, we're losing him.
He's kind of cute.
Oh, jeez.
I thought we were going to be putting the Zora guard as monster food.
No, I was going to use Arbit.
I was going to use the Zora guard.
Just use both. Why not?
Even better. double the distractions.
I did say that there were multiple monsters, so we're gonna need multiple distractions. It's fine.
We should go get two more Zora guards then.
We should find Rova's sister.
Don't say that.
Even better.
Yeah, I was about to say, you're saying any of this out loud?
This is all group huddle whispering.
All right, let's go. Let's go fight monsters.
So,
you accept the quest?
Yes, we will go fight the monsters.
I give him a thumbs up. I'm trying not to talk.
Interesting. Well, who's doing which?
I thought we were all going to fight monster.
Oh, so you're not splitting.
That would be a dumb idea.
It's like they don't want me to get... Daddy, I don't think they want me to get married.
It's okay. It's okay, sweetheart. They're just trying to delay it because the longer you wait, the sweeter it will be, right?
That's because the imminent crab threat, but you know.
I mean, yeah, I'm fine. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay.
So do you want us to go fight the monsters and save your people? Or do you want us to find your little girl a boyfriend?
Is the fluffy one going with them?
I think so.
Can I go
see
watch
if I
them?
Can, I want to see if I can eat the thing that we're fighting.
can I go watch them?
Sure.
Oh, yay!
I look over to Zanzi and I whisper in her ear, I think we might have another beat.
I'm gonna be looking like super angry that we have to bring another princess, and then I'm just gonna look at Goro and smirk.
Whoa.
Oh my goodness.
Now all we need is one more.
Does it have to be now, though? Because it's kind of late, and I'm kind of getting hungry. Can we do it tomorrow?
I thought you were
just
know.
In a hurry. Listen, I thought what happened to savoring it?
Hey, that's right. You're learning, daughter. Yeah, look at that. She's learning. I got wisdom.
Oh, boy. This is something else.
Hey, why don't you guys come eat with us? We got plenty of food. The chefs in the corner just like look up and it's like just dead face staring at him.
Okay. I think I understand. I think I get situation. I know my brain not very fast sometimes, but. I think I get it. So you're saying that you don't care about the monsters eating your people. Got it.
No. They're not. They're eating our people?
Well, they've only eaten one so far. It was, you know, someone that went out of the way down there.
We'll
set up some guards to prevent people from going onto Crab Rock.
People too?
Yeah, well, everyone.
But then want to eat them?
No, we're preventing anyone from going onto the Crab Rock.
But they can come down from the Crab Rock and eat them, can't they?
No, they don't know how to climb.
Then how did they get up on Crab Rock?
Probably the ocean.
Where are people going to Crab Rock?
Usually young couples.
Oh.
Why?
It's a place where, before it got, you know, taken over, it used to be a place where, you know, people would hit it off. And meet people.
Well, they would hit what off?
The crabs? They would hit the crabs?
No! The spark of romance!
I grab Goro by the shoulder and I just shake my head.
I don't get what you mean, little fish person.
It's okay. You don't have to. I know it's hard for you, Goron, since you're asexual, to understand.
I'm what?
And so it's time for dinner.
And that is where we end today's session.
I'm what?
Oh, dear.
I had to throw that in there.
Oh, it's okay.
Too stupid.
It's the cliffhanger.
Alrighty. Yo, welcome into Solid State for your first session. What'd you think?
Oh, that was fun. That was good.
Yes.
I like where this is going.
Yes, I love the party dynamic here. This is good.
Yeah, this is good.
Alrighty. Oh, of course, very sad to see Teus go, but like, you know, it's you being here makes it bittersweet.
Bitter but sweet.
Yes. Alrighty. This is where I changed the music to the ending music. I didn't put on the Zora music. Hold on. Oh, gosh darn it. Anyways.
How could you?
Had it as that chiptune vibe the whole time. Jeez. Anyways. All right. So we're going to... for those of you that haven't seen these people before, most of them are streamers. And one of them should be a streamer. In my opinion. And we're going to let you guys get to know them, but though also with this, we're going to ask a little get to know you question. I want to know this about you guys too in chat. So this is a question to everyone, including chat. All right. I first need to come up with a question though. Let's see if I have something saved. I have a list. I could go all the way back to, like, the first ones that we did at the beginning of PokeQuest at this point. It's been, like, you know, over a year. So probably, you know, opportune time to reuse them anyways. Yeah. This is an interesting one. If your brain were a fortune cookie, like basically, so think of it this way. If I crack open your brain and there's just a piece of paper there, and that piece of paper, the words on it kind of represent just a phrase that represents your brain. A phrase that represents your brain. If your brain were a fortune cookie, what would it say on that slip? A phrase that represents your brain. And then also a lucky number. Who wants to go first? Don't all speak up at once. Jeez, come on.
I'm thinking.
Yeah, this is a thinker.
Mm-hmm. Good. Oh, crap. I need to think about it, too.
Nice.
I can kind of answer this, actually. So I'll do my plug first. I'm Solid State. I don't stream. This is normally the moment when I was in PokeQuest, I would say, "Oh hey, I made some of the art," but I didn't. So here I'm just your. I also don't take notes here, so I'm just your second string, fourth of the Triforce. And I can answer this because I once had a inspirational quote with a picture up like pinned to the wall of my cubicle at my first real job. And it said, "It's a good day to do what has to be done by me and help my brother to defeat the enemies." Which is a quote from Half-Life Full Life Consequences. And that is the weirdly enough, one of the most inspiring things ever, even though it's just a complete gibberish sentence. And my lucky number would be like 9.
Cool. All right, who's next?
I can think of one, I think.
Go ahead.
If it was a fortune cookie, mine would probably say anxiety is the spice of life. And my lucky number would probably be, I don't know, pick one out of the top of my head, 105. Ooh. I don't know. How's it going, everybody? My name is Viridian. I'm a variety streamer here on Twitch. We play a lot of Pokemon, both official and modded, Mario, Zelda, the whole nine yards. Definitely more of an 18 plus streamer, but yeah, if you like chaos, stop on by sometime. We have a lot of chaotically fun times.
There you go. All right, Grovile, do you have one?
Well, my lucky number is 23. I already knew that. Guess probably something cliche, like winners never quit and quitters never win. There we go.
Okay.
Yeah, I stream a lot of Zelda stuff, but also a lot of other random stuff. I used to do a lot of speedruns, but I haven't done a lot of speedruns recently, but I'm trying to get back into them. I was doing a Zelda challenge to try and finish all the Zelda games before Tears of the Kingdom, and then we did that. So now we're waiting for Tears of the Kingdom, so that will be a thing. Yeah, fun times.
There you go, nice. All right, and Rose.
I think mine, I don't think it would be a phrase necessarily. It would just be like the entire song of Menomina, because that's just what my brain works at constantly.
Yeah.
It would just be the entire song just playing on repeat constantly. And then my lucky number would be 3.
Fit it all in.
Yeah. You have to put it on 1.5. What's up, guys? My name is Black Rose. I am a variety streamer. I have not been streaming recently because school is kicking my butt and I hate it, but hopefully I should be getting back to it soon. I am a Christian streamer. I'm in the fellowship with Will, and I have an 18 plus stream solely because we talk about some heavier topics like mental health and, you know, things like that, that I don't necessarily want younger audiences to be a part of, but we have fun. We cause chaos. So, you know, come by if you want.
Yeah. That's the vibe. Hi, my name's Will. Somehow.
Hi, Will.
I think my fortune cookie would just say, like, yep. and just because, like, that's just my vibe. It's like, yep, yeah, yep. Yeah, I just accept everything. It's just like, yep, yep, that happened. Yep. I just go with the flow in life. There's now a process of that was yes, yes, yes. This got redeemed very early on in the stream. And
I genuinely thought, because I had the stream like in little thumbnail mode, that you were just wearing a blonde wig.
Oh, no. I'm still telling me wait 20 seconds before I can shout Rose out. Gosh darn it. Well, anyways, so my vibes, we are a family-friendly Christian streamer, or I am. Anyways, you guys can see at the bottom right my stream schedule. Oh, I didn't put in the new picture. Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays are lunch hour streams, and the evening streams are on Mondays, as you can see. The other every other week is going to be Stardew Valley with Crowd Control with the amazing Catherine Naomi. And then Saturdays, we have streams in the mornings. We do tabletop RPGs and Nintendo games. And then also apparently Stardew now. Wait, how's that work? What has Cap done to me? Anyways. finally, let me shout out Rose. There we go. Yeah, that's the vibe. That's the stuff. Thank you, guys. Yeah. I'm talking to you guys.
Ooh.
Yay!
Yeah.
Oh, that's us.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, all y'all.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Well, we're going to go and figure out who to raid. You guys go ahead and say bye-bye.
Bye.
I love you. Sleep good. Don't forget to drink your water.
Gross. You're banned.
Alrighty, let's go over to the here and yeah. Where? Oh, my cam. That's right. Where am I? Video capture device at existing. There we go. Hello, there I am. I'm not going to bother sizing it. Alrighty, we're going to figure out who to raid here. I know who we're raiding. Never mind. We're going to raid Catherine Naomi, who's also a part of our group of Christian streamers known as the Fellowship. She is amazing. Very fun, very chaotic vibes over there. Cozy chaotic is what she likes to call it, and I agree. And that's where I stole that term from my streams. So we're going to go raid her. We do have a raid message. Copy that first one if you have my emotes. Now, if you do not have my emotes, never fear. That second message is here for you and your clipboard. Specifically your clipboard. Put it in there. All right, and there's a Marie and chat. We can catch that if you Pokemon it. And if you love someone, you tell them the truth. And boy, how do I love you guys. So, wait, what does it mean, invalid username? You're an invalid username. Raid. Catherine. There we go. If you love someone, tell them the truth. Boy, I love you guys. So here's the truth that can be found in 1 Thessalonians 5, 22 through 24. Abstain from every form of evil. Now, may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely. And may your spirit and soul and body be complete, blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, who will also do this. That's our true time for today. That's all the time that we have for today. Make sure you have that raid message copied, everyone, because we're going to go do some raiding, sharing the love and hype with Catherine Naomi. Thank you guys for that hype train to start off the stream with Rose, Teus, and Chrono doing their resubs. No, wait. No, Chrono wait. Why is it not listing solids? Yeah, no, it was Solid Rose and Teus that resubbed. Thank you, guys. Thank you, three. And thank you to Lieutenant Captain Bowser for pressing the friendship button. All right, let's go share the love and hype with our amazing friend Catherine. Bye. Love you all. I do. Love you all. Bye.